So this morning is all about liveys. Didn't have any good bait that I sort of felt in any way confident in bringing, so I'm gonna catch some liveys this morning, try something a little different and troll them around. So normally at Palmy, pretty much just hit the troll baits or the dead baits and troll them fast, cover lots of ground. There's plenty of ground to cover here, but today I'm just gonna try liveys only, take it a little slower, let them do a bit of the work. But first we've got to find them, so eyes on the sounder. So look for those marks. Okay, so we're coming up to the little bait reef now. You see it start to appear on the struct scan. Where is the bait schools though? I see rocks. Alright. Come on, where are they? Don't let me down, bait. Start dropping. No harm in making a few drops. Alright. Always a relief to get some bait in. When you know it's all sort of riding on getting a couple of baits and you can't all of a sudden get any, it's a bit depressing. But we've got a few in already, so. Oh! We're looking good. Okay. So, a couple of back paddles to get us back on the spot. There we go. That way. I want to go that way. Well, we should wind that in. Alright, so we've got some liveys in, which is good. Relatively painless this morning, biting nicely, so that saves us one headache. I know we've sort of loaded up with a decent amount, so I'll take this off, take the jig off, pop it in the back hatch, and then we'll put. See, normally I bring maybe, when I'm live baiting, I usually have like a dedicated sort of jigging rod, but today I just didn't want to sort of muck around with too many rods. So we've got a quick snap clip on here, change it over. Don't usually like using snaps, but we will. Alright, so that's what we'll be rolling with, just a simple live bait rig. And then I've got the other one. The other one is actually the rig that I made in that video. And I'm going to use that for liveys and hopefully catch something on it, just to prove the point that it works. Otherwise I'll edit that out. Alright, so let's get these liveys on and we'll see what happens. Hopefully it won't be a repeat of what happened the other day, which is a lot of paddling and zero catching. Alright, so the baits are out. I never feel really overly good about doing that to them, so it's probably why I didn't show it on camera. Pin it just like I showed you in the other video, pin it just like that. So up under the nose, or through the jaw, up under the chin, and then pop the stinger in the back there. Alright, let's get these out a bit. So I counted maybe 20 seconds for one, or maybe just over 15 seconds for one, and up to about 20, 25 for the next. So just there's a bit of space in between them, because liveys can sometimes tend to swim together. Then we'll just slow troll these everywhere. See, the water does look a little bit better today than it did last time I was out. Still pretty green and brown, but definitely cleared up a little bit. I think, yeah, the temperature's still only 22.8, so that's pretty low. You'd really want it to be at least 23. So as I get out to hopefully hit some blue water, it'll go up to about 23.8, I think, is the warmest I found last time. So we'll find out. Let's put this little plastic out. See what happens with that as well. Usually let that at about 10 meters, so not too far back, so it doesn't get tangled. And we are good to go. All right. What have you got for me today? Today's actually ANZAC Day. I don't know if you could hear those planes flying over, but it's basically our Memorial Day for our soldiers. So I have been to dawn services in the past and it's a pretty solemn moment, but I find these days I can't reflect any better than when I'm out on the water like this. So it's sort of a nice feeling to sort of be out here and you can actually still hear the bugles and see the planes going over, all the old warplanes. So we'll see what ANZAC Day has in store for me. Some interesting sounds on the sounder. You can see some bait sort of that's being pushed up. Plenty of structure on that side there. But we're well and truly in close, so I'll have to move out to all of these marks out here. Bit of a mess here. Oh no! I'm assuming this is going to be a shark. I'm in a bit of a mess tangle wise, that's for sure. Ooh, I got a lot of lines going everywhere. I think I've got another fish on the other one now. All right, this is interesting. Oh, I've got a bit of an issue. I'm not sure. Let's just try and hack away at it. Let's get this out of the way. We have an issue. It's all just wound in around there now. That's no good. What are we gonna do here? Do we cut one off? Might have to. It's because it's wrapped around there. Alright, so we've got to get rid of this. This really breaks my heart to do this. Because I don't know really which one to do. But I'm going to have to do one of them. Okay, we'll concentrate on the first one. There's not much I can do about that. What is this going to be? Such a shark. It's a little less exciting than I want it to be. Hey, hey, hey. Plenty of go in him. Yeah, I almost tempted to take you home and eat you. Ah, you f. That's really annoying. So I've lost all those rigs, snapped a rod on that shark, which is a bit of a bummer. But these bars are everywhere. I've got to have another go at that. So I've just whacked a livey on the bait jig. If I do get something on here, Here we go. Oh, look, it's gonna go. Here we go. Just swallow the whole thing. Come on. Here we go. Whoa! Well, whatever it is, I'm assuming it's just sharks, but this is a bit of fun on the light rod. Let's just enjoy the fight. I am assuming that's another shark for sure. Oh well, this is a good test for the new slammer. See if we can get that drag going. That was fun. Okay, we're up to the orange line already, which means we're 10 meters away. Must be sharks. They must all be sharks. In which case, but I just want to know, my curiosity is getting the better of me, just to see what they are. Come on, just keep coming. Ah, come on. And yep, another shark. Oh, look, he's not happy. Oh, Jesus. He's going berserk. Look at him. Oh, he's tail wrapped himself as well. Oh, I think he's wrapped himself right up. Oh, how are we going to get him off? Well, he was not happy. Ah dear. Bit of a non-event in the end, unfortunately. But at least it satisfied my curiosity. At least I know what I was missing out on. Just in case that other one, just in case there was a mackerel hidden amongst them. But I'd say they're all going to be sharks, so we'll move on. I've got to get in, so that's that, I think, unfortunately. Alright, out you go. Let's get out of here.